He's the Oscar-winning writer and director responsible for getting Tom Cruise to scream "Show Me the Money" and Jerry Maguire. Got Matt Damon to star alongside lions and tigers in We Bought a Zoo. And in 2000, Cameron Crowe told his own story in the semi-autobiographical movie Almost Famous. Well, that movie is now a stage musical, opening last week on Broadway. And Cameron has spoken with CBS correspondent Tracy Smith about transforming Almost Famous into a musical. It's all happening.
Help me, Rod. Help me help you.
Who doesn't remember this? Tom Cruise at the end of his rope.
Help me help you.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
Or Sean Penn's Spicoli.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time? In
your eyes. Or John Cusack's Boombox. Truth is, some of the more memorable moments ever put on film came from writer-director Cameron Crowe. But people tell him the one they really relate to is this.
Hold me closer, tiny dancer.
I have to go home.
Count the headlights on the highway.
You are home.
2000's Almost Famous is his story. He actually was the teen who left home to cover rock and roll.
Am I speaking to you clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
If you harm him in any way.
And the Frances McDormand character was based on his real mom, Alice.
You will meet the voice at the other end of this telephone, and it will not be pretty. Do we understand each other?
Yes, ma'am.
I didn't ask for this role, but I'll play it.
And the Oscar goes to Cameron Crowe for Almost Famous.
The film wasn't an immediate hit, but it caught on in home rentals. And for Crowe, it was among his career highs.
The movie was a love letter to music and to my family.
And now, 22 years later, that love letter is being read again, 8 times a week.
I look down, 'cause I can't see straight, and mom's cooking again, so thank God I ate.
Almost Famous, the musical, opened on Broadway last week. Faithful to the movie and more.
If you're gonna tell the story correctly, that's a personal story, you have to get personal.
Even if it's painful.
Sometimes, most of all.
Cameron Crowe grew up in San Diego and lived for a time with his mother and sister in this building. Their apartment was actually in the basement.
How long has it been since you've been back here?
50 years.
50 years?
Yes.
This is it, yeah.
Oh man, wow. I want to start listening to Joni Mitchell and Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Black Sabbath. I can feel it coming. Holy mackerel. This totally feels like home. Gotta check out the kitchen for a
minute. Yeah, go.
Yes, the vast expanse. But it's okay, because my mom was not a good cook.
But Alice Crowe was a college professor, and she had definite ideas about what her kids were learning.
Your mom didn't want any rock and roll.
She just felt that rock and roll was going to destroy brain cells.
But their apartment was just down the hill from San Diego's Old Globe Theater, and she'd take him there to see Shakespeare.
And your mother made you go to these plays.
Made me go. Demanded.
Of course, he'd thank her later.
Hello.
William Miller.
This is he.
William, this is Ben Fong Torres. I'm the music editor at Rolling Stone magazine.
Just like the kid in his movie, young Cameron started writing for rock magazines. Cream, Rolling Stone, and eventually graduated to screenplays and directing. Mom was proud, of course, but she wanted him to write a musical based on Almost Famous. In time, he did, and by 2019, he was ready to stage it. Where else? At the Old Globe. But only days before the first ever preview, Mrs. Crowe, who was in her 90s, had a bad fall and slipped into a coma. Anika Larson plays the Alice Crowe character in the show.
Did you get a chance to meet Alice?
I did.
Larson asked Cameron to let her go to Alice's bedside.
They say people in comas can hear, so he took me to the hospital. I held her hand, I introduced myself to her. I sang her three songs for her. I thought, if she can't come to the show, we bring the show to her. And then he took me back and we did our first dress rehearsal that night. And she died that night.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. It was a lot, yeah.
And so the first audiences came in just after we'd lost her. And, you know, I felt her spirit every night. I feel it here now. To her last breath, she was saying, never give up. Tell this story. And we did.
In spite of it all, opening night in San Diego was a triumph. Joni Mitchell was in the crowd, and celebration was in the air.
And they would say, so are you going to go to Broadway? And I'm like, you know, we have Tonight. People really loved it. And Joni Mitchell loved it. She actually thought it was better than the movie. If nothing ever happens, I'm good.
But in the end, he couldn't resist the chance to see his mother's dream happen.
Don't you dare break his spirit!
And the cast packed their bags for Broadway. I'm lost in New York City. And now, after a 3-year pandemic delay, it's all happening. Broadway composer Tom Kitt wrote a score that sounds both familiar and completely new.
Do you feel like you always ignore the desire to go and explore Morocco?
What was it like putting on that coat for the first time?
Oh my God, addictive.
Soleil Pfeiffer is Penny Lane, the role made famous by Kate Hudson.
It's all happening.
It's all happening.
One thing that is really exciting to me is that there was everyone who could see themselves in Kate Hudson, and now as a woman of color stepping into this role, you know, little girls like me get to see themselves in this role. So I feel like it just like cracked the door open just enough.
It's all happening.
It's all happening.
But beyond the music and the cast and the lights of Broadway, it's really about one family and a dream finally come true.
What is it like seeing your story come to life like this, night after night?
Sometimes it rubs deeply, and sometimes it kind of opens up some raw memories. But to see your own life up there kind of with veins opened, you know, it's sometimes overwhelming.
So what do you think Alice would think of all this?
She would want three seats for, like, two of her friends on each side. And she would be there every night, just like she is. You do get messages from your loved ones. And I definitely know she's here.